so hard living this life, a constant struggle each and every day.
There are many people some living in the city, some good, some bad, but all individually unique, looking to express themselves in their own way. Across the dirt roads, city streets, highways, byways, and interstates in this life, someone, some mysterious being from out there, can just with one small word keep a person like me or you from going over the edge. Today we explore these people who are the people of the city.
I wanna be free.
No, you won't be naming no building.
Now the biggest misconception with slavery is the slave didn't get paid. Now the slave didn't get a paycheck, but they definitely got paid. They got the leftover food that master didn't want to consume, a few clothes and a place to stay. And that's exactly what you get with minimum wage. You get just enough something to give you the guts to get up and do that shit again the next day. 9 to 5, 40 hours a week, and every other Sunday. And master no longer gonna beat a slave to make him behave. Now they just dock your pay or fuck with your sick days. Or put you on that 12 to 6 graveyard shift, got you busting your dick from dust and dawn, but you still don't have a phone and can barely keep your lights on.
Show live!
A little extra cost in life. Sometimes the slaves are forced to resort to commit petty crimes. You see those slaves live back in the day, not only were they brave, but they had to live bold, because whenever that weather got blistering cold, them slaves had to break into master's home to steal warm blankets and extra clothes. And that's the very reason why, this very day and time, black people in America are still associated with crime. Which brings me to the 13th Amendment, which clearly mentions the slave of the boss of all persons, except for those convicted of a crime. So plantations become penitentiaries and correctional facilities, where the state pays the inmate 8 cents an hour, provides for food, clothes, and a shower, and a place to stay. And that's when the warden forces that prison to produce product, the state turns right back around and sells on the open market. That's slavery 101, baby, regardless of what you want to call it. I mean, what if all these Walmart stores existed way back in the year 1712? Who in the hell you think would have been working the cash register than stocking the sales? See, it doesn't matter if you're just a prisoner, pressing that license plate in the prison system, or just some burger flipping, tomato picking, Mexican immigrant, or just some auto factory worker working up in Flint, Michigan. Slavery is the heartbeat of capitalism, and capitalism is the beast that don't sleep. That's why there's cocaine on every corner and 24-hour TV. And believe me, I know y'all don't want to hear this shit from me, but until a slave knows that he's slave, he'll never be free. And believe me, I know that I'm the modern-day bird than that turtle, so I'm not all that concerned about egos I might be hurting. Cause see, I can tell by the looks from some of you, you don't think the slavery rule even applies to you. But America's first form of slavery is indentured servitude. So if you want these people that can barely make the minimum monthly payment, no credit card bill and statement, then go ahead and consider yourself a slave too. Cause you no longer work for you. You merely just a slave that banking institution in front of you, the credit to buy shit you couldn't afford in the first place. Got you living on a beer budget with champagne taste. Can't emancipate yourself cause you gotta pay them high ass interest rates. Not to mention all the late fees you gotta pay when your payment is late. So you run around here thinking that you earned a good living because you got a good job with a pension, but if you got a poor credit score, you better believe that you will proceed as a second-class citizen. Why you think?
Hey.
Why you think the government wasn't in no hurry to help them Hurricane Katrina victims? That's because America and slavery live together in perfect harmony. Never going back to the plantation, so massa can kiss my narrow black ass.
Yeah!
Made me wanna holler the way that through my life. This ain't living, this ain't living. No, no, baby, this ain't living. No, no. No chance to increase finance. Bills pile up sky high. Send that boy off to die.
I'm trying to find a piece of swine to get hunger off my mind. I done fell on hard times and I pray it get better. I've been through the change in the weather without a sweater or two sticks to rub together. But at least I ain't on drugs. I do parking for clubs and I clean mud for a pay stub. And sweeping barbershops don't pay much, but I still do it. I be the best at changing your fluid. I had the ball and I blew it. Fourth quarter, two at the line. But doing lines was the only thing that was on my mind. I'm glad I quit that habit, but it helped numb the pain of raindrops in the spring full of rain. And when the summer hit, that's another story. I didn't mean to bore the only people to ever listen to my story, but I need some change. I'm caught out there, man, and things will never be the same.
We all have a destiny in this life. Keep rising, keep striving, keep focused on what you gotta do and not worrying about anybody else, and keep your faith in the Creator.
My world, it moves so fast today.
Keep your faith in you.
The past, it seems so far away.
And you will
and life
achieve your
so
fullest destiny.
I can't breathe.
You will.
And every time I try to be what someone else thought of me,
spread your wings,
so caught up,
and fly, baby,
to achieve,
fly, baby.
But deep in my heart, the answer, it wasn't me. And I'm made up my mind to define my own destiny. Many cry for help, searching outside of themselves.